So Pooja, you had your interviews. Can you tell me how many interviews you want to share today? Experience of how many interviews you want to share today?
Interviews, one from Civil Engineering Department and another one from Center of Energy. Both are from IIT Guwahati.
IIT Guwahati, Civil Engineering and Center for Energy. Which course?
I am from Civil Engineering.
No, which course? M.Tech, PhD, MS, which course?
PhD, sir. Direct PhD.
Both PhDs, right, Pooja?
Yes, sir.
Okay, before we proceed, Pooja, forward for PhD in Civil Engineering and Energy Science Department of IIT Guwahati, I want your very brief introduction in the sense, what is your CGPA, what is your GATE score, what is your category? This information, Pooja.
Okay, sir. My CGPA is 8.92. My category is general, and I don't have a valid GATE score. I'm a non-GATE student. I applied under the self-financed category, actually.
Great. So self-finance category in all these two departments you applied and then you got the call, right, Pooja?
Yes, sir.
Perfect. Perfect. So now let's go first to IIT Guwahati, PhD, Civil Engineering, Pooja.
Okay, sir.
Tell in detail now.
Okay.
How was it?
There were like
and
four
also
professors.
please tell me whether they asked you for research proposal or something or not.
No, sir, they didn't ask for research proposal. While submitting the application form, we were to submit the SOP. That's it. No research proposal detail, that thing and
Okay.
all. So there were four professors in the panel, and one professor asked my introduction, brief introduction, and then what is my project, and then asked about what do you want to do in PhD in civil
Okay.
engineering. I said I want to do nonlinear analysis of bridges.
Okay.
I have also done an NPTEL courses on bridge engineering. Then he handed over to another professor. So he started with maths, and
Okay.
he asked me to form a second order differential equation.
Okay.
I formed the equation and showed it to him. He said, "How will you solve it?" Then I wrote the auxiliary equation. Then he asked me a question: "Why did you separated that?" We usually separate that variable y outside the equation. I asked why that y is gone. Where is why? Why did you do that? And I said it's a variable. We are taking only differential operators in the auxiliary equation. Then he said if there is something on the right hand side, let's say he said p sine lambda x. Then how will you solve it? When I was thinking, he just shifted to solve this using Laplace transform. I said I'm not comfortable with Laplace transform that much. Then he said, "Okay, no problem," and started asking me state of materials questions. He told me to draw a cantilever beam, and then he told to give a point load at the center and a torsional spring at the free end. Then he told how will you solve it. I said I will apply superposition principle first. I'll separate the point load and the torsional spring, and I wrote down the formula for the point load to be deflection equation. I wrote PL square by 2EI, that equation. He asked me where from you got this equation. I told we used to take the section and then we used to calculate the moment, and I forgot suddenly the double integration method name. I was like thinking, he didn't give much time to think, and he said, "Okay, no problem." Then next professor will ask the question. He moved on to next professor. He asked me, "What are the subjects you prepared for this interview?" I said, "Strength of materials and the design of reinforced concrete elements." He asked me, "DRC, how you prepare?" I said, "Yes," and then he continued with, "What is the moment carrying capacity of a over reinforced section?" I answered. He was not okay with my answer, and then he asked me, "Okay, tell me how will you calculate the neutral axis depth of a over reinforced section?" I told him that a formula. He said, "It's for balanced section. Give me exact method. How will you do it for over reinforced section?" So we usually don't consider over reinforced section design. So we focused a little on that. So I said, "No, sir. I'm not getting the right thing you are asking." And then he moved on to Castigliano's theorem. I was very nervous at that point. I said there were three Castigliano's theorem. Suddenly they got okay, and actually only two Castigliano's theorems were there. Suddenly, he said, "Okay, no problem. I will finish the interview," and that interview was over.
Okay, so you think very less questions were asked in technical?
Yes, sir. I feel like that. And suddenly, as I gave the wrong answer, they
Finished
concluded the
it.
interview. Yeah,
So
I
there were
said
three
very bad.
professors. Three professors?
Yes, sir.
One was...
I think one professor was under mute. He didn't interact.
So one was mathematics and one was technical. And third was...
One professor just had introduction. One professor asked maths and strength of material. Another one professor asked DRC, design of reinforced concrete structures.
Okay. So now, Pooja, tell me, after every interview, you have some kind of learning, right? You always think, okay, I could have done better in this way. What was the learning after this interview of IIT, your Guwahati for civil engineering?
So usually, civil engineers don't focus on Laplace transform. It's not like very important chapter. Even in gate, it's removed. So suddenly, they asked a Laplace transform question and I was stunned. I should have prepared in that way also. For interview, I should have covered everything. And then they had a correct threshold of things that we do it mechanically. Sometimes we do things without consciousness, why we do this. They had a correct threshold of those things and they were asking about those things. I was like, couldn't think, and they were expecting fast answers. So that made me like feel what exactly, when people say prepare the basic part, prepare the derivation part, that thing I came to know after this interview.
Okay. So now if you are to advise somebody how to prepare, what you will say?
So I will say to focus on derivation more than the end results. In gate, we use just numerical, very short techniques to get an answer in 2 minutes. Those things we should not do in interview.
Okay.
You have to, if they are asking a deflection, you have to do it by double derivation method and show the answer. Yeah.
So spend some time in solving, writing and explaining, right?
Yeah.
Great, Pooja.